This is Pastor John. We're on the phone with Pastor Marti from Indiana, who we know for many, many years. And here's what happened. We've been, got a lot of situations going on, our close friends and partners. You know about some of the trials and tribulations and persecutions. And it's been difficult. But I was praying this morning all night. 3 o'clock in the morning, there was an awesome presence of God in the room. I mean, it was so awesome, it was kind of like scary. It was, I felt the presence of God many times, but it was like, he was standing right there next to me. I mean, I can feel him, it was awesome. And I had some good prayer, and God gave me some good scriptures. And then about 5 o'clock in the morning or so, I fell asleep. 7 o'clock in the morning, Pastor Marti called. And I didn't know she was texting me because I was sleeping. But she started to text and then said, the heck with this, and she decided to call. And she gave me some really nice words of encouragement that I want to share with our friends and partners, nice people like you. So Pastor Marti, we love you. We're praying for you. These people know, because we've been praying for you, that her husband, don't make me mushy, went home to be with the Lord. He had some heart problems and then the virus. And, but Pastor Marti, strong woman of God, and she's going on. In Jesus' name. All right, Pastor Marti, what do we have to say?
Well, so this morning at 6:34, I know exactly what time it was, the Lord woke me up. And the first thing, I had been praying for you, Pastor John, before I went to bed. And I had just praying, you know, over the situation. But he woke me up this morning and he said, I heard those words from this scripture that's in Ephesians. And you all know it. It's that we may really come to know the love of Christ, which far surpasses knowledge, and that we may be full with all the fullness of God, that we may have the richest measure of his divine presence. And you know, the end of that where it says, and I'll read it to you in a minute, that he can do super abundantly, far over and above all that we dare ask or think. And if you've got, I'm just going to read the beginning of it because that's where God started. I'm going to read it to you out of the Amplified. But it says in Ephesians 3:16, and it says, may he grant you out of the rich treasury of his glory to be strengthened, reinforced with his mighty power in your inner man by the Holy Spirit himself, who will indwell your innermost being and personality. May Christ, through your faith, actually dwell, settle down, abide, and make his permanent home in your hearts. And may you be rooted deep in his love and founded securely on your love. Verse 18, that you may have the power and be strong to apprehend and to grasp with all the saints, God's devoted people, the experience of that love. What is the breadth and the length and the height and the depth of that love? That you may really practically come to know through experience for yourself the love of Christ, which far surpasses mere knowledge without experience, that you may be filled throughout all your being unto the fullness of God. Wow. That you may have the richest measure of his divine presence and become a body wholly filled and flooded with God himself. And now, unto who, by in consequence of this action of his power or love, that is at work within us, is able to carry out his purpose and do super abundantly, far over and above all that we even dare ask, think, or infinitely beyond our highest prayers, desires, thoughts, hopes, or dreams. That's a wow. But the Lord brought that to me, and it was the last sentence I just read to you, that he can do super abundantly above what we would ever, and in us, what we could ever dare ask, think, or hope, highest prayers, desires, thoughts, or dreams. And I don't think sometimes we realize, I know I don't, what power has been deposited in us by by the love of Jesus. It said by the Holy Spirit himself. And so the Lord brought to me this morning, and I was like shaken. He said, remember when Pastor John first came? We're talking 37 years ago. And I was raised Methodist, free Methodist, but we really weren't free. But I was raised Methodist, and my cousin Judy invited me to go to a meeting on the square in a little room, a little storefront church, and to see here Pastor John, Prophet Pastor John DeLacio. I said, well, I never heard of Prophet before. And so I asked my dad, and he said, he was free Methodist. He said, nope, don't go to those meetings, Mark. I said, okay. But I had an unction. I needed to go. And so I went. And my husband didn't go with me. I went with my cousin Judy. And my dad said, you know, she's just a little weird. She loves God, but she's a little weird. But anyway, I went. So I walked in, and Jen wasn't with me. And I sat with my cousin Judy. And Pastor John began to walk around like he does. And you know, the Holy Spirit's talking to him. And I didn't know it at that time. And he said, who in your family's name starts with J? It's a fancy J. And I said, my husband, Jan. And then he said, he's called to preach. And he has been bound by religiosity and by religion. But anyway, that was what he said. Well, when Jan and I got married, he came from the Pentecost background. And because his wife left him and divorced him, and then he married me, you know, in the Pentecost, you're done. The gift and callings may be without repentance with God, but if you're Pentecost, you're done. So Jan thought he was done. Well, there was nobody I knew in that church except my cousin Judy. So I was just overwhelmed with the power of God that brought that word to me. So the next night I brought my husband, but he said he wasn't going to sit with me because he didn't want Pastor John to know who he was. And so he said, you know, I was praying for you today about that fancy J. And I go, oh, he's right over there. Jen let it kill me. So then Pastor John began to prophesy to him. And he said that God was getting ready to do a work in him. And he said, you may not remember this, Pastor John, but you said he's getting ready to do a work in your in-laws and your outlaws. Well, his ex-father-in-law that he adored got saved within 2 weeks of that meeting and had never gone to church. And my father came to those meetings, his in-laws, and changed his life forever. And so we were just, that word, that power of the love of God in Pastor Jan changed this family's life. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to tell you one more. My sister came then later of the revival because, you know, we were doing, God was doing such amazing things. And we were all free Methodists. You know, we hadn't been exposed to this kind of power of God. And I was slain in the spirit. I never had that done before. Didn't even heard about it. Didn't know about it. But it was the most marvelous thing that ever happened to me. So then my dad came and my sister came. So the day that my sister came to the meetings, she had been to the doctor and she was pregnant with her second child. And the doctor said, go home and you're gonna have a miscarriage. And when you do come to the hospital, we'll do a DNC and you're going to miscarry. So she came to the meeting that night. And Pastor John, I don't know if you remember because God used you so powerfully. But you said there's someone here and they got a report today from the doctor that they're going to have a miscarriage. Well, she hadn't even told me that yet. And you said, stand. And so I had lunch with her today and she said, yes. And he stood and he came up and he laid hands on me and prayed for me. My dad, who told me not to go to the meetings, was there too because he was watching. And you said, you're going to have a girl and you're not going to miscarry and it will be an easy pregnancy. Well, that girl that was going to be miscarried is now got one little girl and is pregnant with her second baby. Power of God. And God has done, there, I can tell you about 10 more, but what God was showing me this morning is that's the power of his love that's in Pastor John, and I don't know how many thousands of families all over this nation and the world, that caused our family to completely turn because we had experienced the power of the Holy Spirit, and our lives were changed. And after that, Jen and I went to KCM. I was on staff with Brother Copeland. I traveled with him on the road. They ordained us, licensed us, and sent us up here to start this church with $15,000. And we've been going since 2004. Jen and I have been to Ecuador. We've seen so many miracles, signs, and wonders in people's lives saved. We were on the broadcast with Brother Copeland. We were on the front of the BVOV. And Pastor John, none of that would have happened Yeah. That rich power of his love, which comes in the anointing and gives you the, it says in the one translation, it says, in all the dimensions of God. True. That anointing, that power of the love of God in you touched my whole family's life and causes so much harvest and seed to be go throughout. I mean, we'll never know till we get to heaven how far reaching that seed is. Because you came to Bedford and you were obedient. And you know, at one time you stayed at our house after you kept coming year after year. And we watched you. So many miracles in my family's life because you were obedient. And what does God say in the last paragraph? He says, now to him and the consequence of this power that is at work within us is able to carry out his purpose and do super abundantly far over and above all we dare ask or think. Or even beyond our wildest, highest prayers, imaginations, desires, thoughts, hopes, or dreams. But God has the power. So as we just come together to pray for you, Pastor John, I wanted to encourage you for the power. And I had the privilege of being around some of the greatest generals of the time. When you travel with Brother Copeland, and I've been with him in many states, and you see some of the greatest generals. I was in the room with Oral Roberts when he came to EMIC because of those things that God put me in, the places. But I personally have never seen a prophet that was as accurate in a service ministering to the people as I've seen with you. I know everybody has different callings, but the giftings and the love and the power of God in you can change lives forever. And I thank God that he sent John DeLacio to Bedford, Indiana, to that storefront church, because it changed our family's life. And God is not done yet.
Amen.
That's my part.
You're going to make me cry.
Amen.
You guys changed my life too, because we went back to Indiana after you started the church, and we had meetings in so many different towns. God's done so many great things. And to God be all the praise and the glory and the honor. Well, we love you. We really appreciate it. And our friends and partners, we just want to say we support you, but you have fruit. You sent me to Indiana and Montana and North Dakota and South Dakota and Wisconsin and here, there, and everywhere. You have fruit abound to your account in heaven.
Amen. So,
this is good ground. Continue to keep your support coming because our best days and years are ahead of us. Where we're getting our biggest resistance, we're going to get our biggest breakthrough.
Amen.
Unity. Pray for Pastor Marti as she carries on the work there in Bedford and her Bible study. Your Bible study is going to be online pretty soon, right?
It was, and then my sister, she has four books coming out, so we had to take a break. But I've had four people today send me emails and say, could you please put it back on? So we'll probably be back on within a week or two. We just have to take a little recess because my sister had to be out of town. She was out of town for 3 weeks going different places, but we'll be back on.
All right, and the name of your church is Stonegate Faith Christian Center, right?
Stonegate Faith Center, FFC, Stonegate Faith Center. Amen.
Email address if somebody wants to contact you.
Stonegate Faith Center at att.net. Or you can go to the website, StonegateFaithCenter.org. Either one of those.
StonegateFaithCenter.org. Right. Yes. Say the email address slower again.
Let's see. StonegateFC. It's just FC at att.net.
Okay.
StonegateFC at att.net.
Well,
it's hard sometimes to remember them all.
Give all my friends there in Indiana a big hug. Tell them we love them and looking forward to seeing them again before we get to the clouds of glory.
Amen. And
we're praying for you, but give everybody up there our love. I'm sure you're encouraging these people and you encourage me. And what you make happen for others, God will make it happen for you. Good measure. Press down, check it together, and run over. All right, we love you. We'll talk to you soon. Thanks again.
All right, love you all. Bye-bye.
And those of you that are listening to this recording, this telephone conversation, our email address. is Pastor John DeLacio at yahoo.com. We have a website, heartlandglobal.org or pastorjohndelacio.org, where you can go to PayPal and give an offering. Or donations can be mailed to, Heartland Christian Center, P.O. Box 680307, Orlando, Florida, 32868. Thank you so much, everybody. We love you. We'll talk to you soon. God bless.